gorgeous afternoon to open an Easter weekend softball series as the Tigers host the Boston College Eagles. Hi, everybody. Fred Cunningham with Scott Whitlock. You get a full count at 3-2.
You certainly don't want to walk a leadoff batter of a ball game.
She will not as she gets her striking out looking, and there's one down. She has started all 130 games of her career, so she showed up at BC and was ready to go. Grounder to Brown, the throw to Hiller, two down. Yeah. She had a big midweek game against Dartmouth.
Yeah.
It's a grounder right there that's going to be fielded by Brown. The quick throw, not in time, and Guyrie beats it out for a two-out base hit.
Yep.
And she's aboard, and that brings up the other freshman in this top four, the cleanup hitter. That is Gator Robinson, who tries to bunt her way aboard, but the ball goes foul. You're on the right side of your screen.
Yep.
And they're going to call it a foul ball.
Foul ball came back. No catch to hit right here.
Pops it up. Cagle settles under it in right field, and the side's retired. Boston College gets a runner aboard but leaves him. We go. Full count. Swing and a miss.
Threw that one right by
her. Number one. Yeah.
The ball up in the zone.
Grounder deep into the hole. Robinson can't hang on to it, and Mackenzie Clark is aboard. The 3-1 runner going, but it doesn't matter because Cagle is able to take the walk, and there's two aboard now for the Tigers. Two balls, two strikes. Clark at second, Cagle at first. Picks a cut and misses.
Threw that one right by her. That was 70 miles an hour.
It's like glove pop. I can't imagine what it's like catching it. 3-1. She will walk and the bases are loaded. That one gets away from the catcher. Clark comes sliding in and the Tigers are on the board.
Well, there you go. When you can't find the strike zone, I mean, she is putting everything she's got into those her power pitches. And when you don't have control, they get by the catcher in a hurry.
Clark reacted quickly, turned on the jet, and it's a 3-0 count to her.
And that's and a 4-0 count.
Yep. Bases are loaded again with one run already in.
Okay, you got to run in right now. You've got
grounder. It is handled by Robinson, who gets the force. The side's retired, and a pretty good break for Dunning and Boston College. Tigers get a run across, but that's it. 1-0 Clemson after one.
Right now.
Elizabeth LaViolette, the left fielder, gets hit by a pitch, and very quickly, Virginia Tech's got a run. Or, you got me talking Virginia Tech. Boston College has. So BC with their second base runner and trying to lay down a bunt quickly, and advancing the runner is McKenna Siegel. She does her job and they get grounder up the middle. It's handled by Lungaleo. The throw goes high over the head of Hiller. Runner advances to third, but LaViolette had to hold there, but
each other. There's a gap between the hands on the bat. See that? See that little gap?
And she goes down swinging. Strikeout.
Same pitch, same spot.
Strikes her out. And Spencer celebrating for good reason. Boston College got two aboard, but full count to Grace Hiller.
Missed in.
Yep, and she's aboard, a leadoff walk.
I don't think Dunning agreed with that. When you've got a blank board to work with, I mean, you can make it anything you wanted to right off, right out of the gate.
BC cannot turn the double play, although they get the force on the job by Guyrie. 2-1 pitch to Alex Brown. Runner going, and that one's going to go deep in the hole. No play for Gator Robinson, and you got runners at first and second.
And that
pitch from Dunning. Popped it up. That's going to be off the glove of LaViolette. Around will come one run, two runs, and it's going to be Clark coming in safe at third. Two more on the board for the Tigers. It's 3-0.
Glove, as you'll see here, LaViolette gets a glove on it, but in the process knocks it away, and it goes all the way out there to the center field wall. And by the time everything was done,
to Valerie Cagle. Fly ball, Jordan Stevens calls for it. Clark on her way home will get the third run of the inning and the fourth overall for the Tigers. And Clark, that was deep enough to get her across, as Noller takes the first pitch and takes it all the way to the wall. So Noller gets her first pitch, her first hit, I should say, in more than a month. Look at that celebration. And she's gonna drive that one for a hit. Coming around is Noller. She will score. Maddie Moore standing up at second. It's an RBI double, and it's 5-0.
Stand up double and an RBI, and that is a two out hit. Draw a circle around it.
Her 22nd run batted in of the season makes it 5-0. And with Lungaleo up, the situation remains the same. Lungaleo walked the first time up. She's at 283. Fly ball, it's deep, 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 gone.
I'll tell you what, she got on that one, and we saw that wind blowing from right center to left center. We saw the wind help that ball out of the park.
Home run number 6 for Aaliyah Lungaleo. It's a two-run shot, 7-0 Tigers. They've got 6 on the board here in the second.
And you'll see right here, as a moonshot, the ball was very high. I didn't know if it was going to get out or not, but it just kept carrying in that wind.
You can see her around first, and she sees it, and Aaliyah celebrating now as the Tigers have really broken it open. That's their 6th hit.
Yeah.
And BC having one homer, 9 RBIs. Grounder found its way to Emma Jackson, and Jackson makes the throw, and that will retire the side. Clemson scores 6 in the second. It's now 7-0.
She doesn't seem to be fazed by being thrust in the top of the order in the Division I softball game.
Grounder right to Moore. The short flip over to Hiller. First out of the inning.
And Maddie Moore did something right there that is, but you've got to come and get the ball and control the hops.
Hannah Slyke, the catcher, grounded out to third, first time up. Grounder, right to Hiller. Hiller steps on the base, 2 away. I'd love to see their recruiting schedule and just
budget.
Yeah, well, that too.
I mean, they're doing a great job.
Yeah. 2 balls and a strike. There's going to be the second hit of the day for Guyrie, and she strokes a single into left.
Run it down.
You mean she can't make every single play?
Well, she could, but I guess that she just chose not to then.
Big swing, and that's a strikeout, and Boston College is retired.
Like, hey, we're not going away this weekend.
Fly ball.
That's
deep
a pretty
left
good message.
Field. That one is gone. An 0-2 home run for Grace Hiller, and the Tigers now are up 8-0.
And the young pitcher just made a mistake.
Look,
and Hiller made her pay for it.
Look at the reception when she gets to home plate. That's her first homer of the season. Only her second RBI. Wow.
Yeah.
Addison Jackson's pitch and gets her swinging for the strikeout. Team All ACC a year ago when she was with the Tar Heels. There's a grounder, Gator Robinson, second out of the inning.
She does a very good job of filling her position. You watch the shortstop. It's just going to come right through and make.
Reagan Spencer working on a three-hit shutout at the moment as she faces Elizabeth Laviolette, who pops up the first pitch behind the plate and able to make the grab. Nice job behind the plate.
A one pitch out.
And how about that right there? That's a hit after what should have been an out in foul territory. And right now, Oda is in left field, and she's topping to saying that's on me. That's on me. It's been tremendous this season, both in the top 16 in the country. And that one's going to be a hit that's going to go beyond the glove of Cagle as she tried to come in and make the play. They will send the runner home, and Boston College is on the board, and BC is celebrating, as they should be. They're in, and this one goes under her glove and then goes beyond her and goes back to the wall.
Well, once it got by her, you knew the run was going to score. But that's going to go as a triple all the way, I'm sure.
Pennsylvania. Still only one out. That one's popped right back to Spencer. And there's now two away. Came all the way from Louisiana to the Northeast. 1-1 pitch. That's hit at Lungaleo, who makes the long throw. And that's all for BC here in the fourth. But the Eagles get on the board with their first run. We go to the bottom of the fourth. Tigers by 7. In the second. Pop that one up. Chasing after it and coming all the way from shortstop to make the play and get the first out of the inning was Gator Robinson. Guyrie might have been closer to it, but she actually tripped and fell over third. 3-2 pitch. And Noller's on board for the second time today.
Probably going to see a pinch runner for Noller right here. Let's see who it'll be. If it's as normal, it will probably be number 6.
Yep. Runner going is Baumhard, and she slides in, and she's going to get one base, and she's going to try to get two, and she gets them both.
You're going to have a stolen base and a error on the throw from the catcher. Slyke.
9 steals on the season now for Baumhard. Slyke, the catcher, does pick up that error. Clemson trying to get the run back that they gave up in the top half of this inning. That's going to go out of here. Man, she just kind of drilled that like a 3-iron. And it went over the head of Laviolette, and it's a 2-run shot for Maddie Moore.
And that ball was sizzled out of here. Like you said, that ball might have gotten 10 foot high, maybe. But
here's the 2-2. Popped it up. Coming in for it is Stevens, and there's two down.
What the viewership doesn't know is that I'm bitter by no. Known him 35 years. But he is a gentleman's gentleman, great family man.
Grounder is handled by Siegel, and that retires the side. Handled by Moore, long throw, not in time. Great effort by Maddie Moore, but good hustle by Jackson to get aboard.
Yep, and that was a prototypical all club.
And that's going to be a hit. Yep. And suddenly, BC has the first two aboard here in the fifth.
I don't know if we got to replay this, but
here's Duncan's pitch. Grounder, and that's going to get through. 3 straight hits, but it's not deep enough to get the run across. They hold up Jackson at third. Yeah, look at that.
Now they back up and they go corners in, 2 in the middle.
And that's going to be through for another hit. Fourth hit of the inning for BC. They'll get one run across as in to make it now 10-2.
And you're going to see Reagan Spencer come right back in this ball game.
Four straight singles for Boston College.
Yeah. And she.
And John Rittman, as you said, goes right to talk to her.
And Coach Rittman doesn't really have.
Two balls, two strikes.
And there
big
it was.
Strikeout yeah. right there. You want to get an out, and she gets her fifth strikeout. And popped it up.
Well, you can't order anything better than that right there.
That fell right into JoJo Hyatt's glove. She was in the right spot. Hyatt coming in. Popped it up. Chasing after it is Hiller, and Hiller brings it in, and that's your ball game. So four straight singles to get the inning started, but the Tigers bring Reagan Spencer back in, and she shuts the door, and the Tigers take the opener of this three-game series.
Was that not an incredible job by Reagan Spencer? She just came in and did what you want a veteran to do. She just shut the door. She said, nope, we're going home. The game is over. And it all started with getting that big strikeout on the first batter she faced.